clock. Hey, let's do the limbo rock.
And we're back. Oh, whoops. I gotta fist it. There we fist go. The this is significantly better.
Yep.
Alright. This kind of reminds me of like Casino Night Zone in Sonic 3.
I did not play.
Really?
Yeah, I played Sonic 3.
This basically is, hey Syam, did you play? Nah.
No, fuck you, I played 3. Wait, 1, 2, 3, and Sonic and Knuckles. Sonic and Knuckles was the best because you could put 2 and 3 into the fucking cartridge and play Knuckles in those games. It was awesome. Right.
I have 30 seconds to kill some bitches.
I'm sure it'll be challenging. Man, Devil Trigger really doesn't go up too fast in this one. Not that it really matters.
No, I don't have enough Devil Trigger to trigger. Wow. No, oh, that edgy look. Okay.
Dante McEdges.
Also, thanks to you, I've had like the Transformers the movie soundtrack like in my head for the past week.
You are welcome. And so have I.
Yeah, like even at work when like I do absolutely nothing heroic at all, I feel like I've got the touch.
You got the touch!
But really, everything, all we do at work is we just dare to be stupid.
Yeah.
Yep. Alright. And it also reminded me of this time I was up super late one night back when I was in uni, not doing any uni work. But someone on 4chan was like streaming the Terminator movies. And I started watching around Terminator 3, which is horrible.
Yes.
But when you're just talking shit with a bunch of dudes, it's pretty alright.
Yeah.
And that scene when Arnie just like busts out of the crypt with like all these guns, the dude just started playing the touch over it. And it just made that scene perfect. And then afterwards it's like, oh, do you want to watch Terminator 4? And I'm like, oh, it's really bad, but why not? And then finished watching all of it, and the dude that was streaming was like, wow, I know that movie is horrible because there was not a single point that could have been improved by playing the touch.
And that's how you know.
Yep.
Everything can be made better by Stan Bush.
Even if it's like good, like,
yeah.
You can't make it worse with that song.
Or dare.
Yeah, that's just hype. Even though it's played at like a really shitty part in the movie when it's basically like, hey, you're gonna get fucked by the Decepticons. I forgot how like grim that movie was.
It's so fucking grim.
Like that first bit when like the Decepticons like board that ship from the moon,
oh,
and just kill all the Autobots on board.
You
that's
know what,
depressing.
To be fair, they had it coming.
That's
I'm
so
gonna dive out of cover and shoot the Decepticons.
It's so depressing. Like such heroic nonsense. Oh, that movie is harsh.
Actually, no. Dare first shows up when
they're going to
when
watch.
When they go to see the landing.
Yeah, and yeah. Then they see that the Decepticons are in the ship. And it's just real sad.
Being badass. As shit.
Yeah.
Turbo Revan, young punk. I straighten out. Yeah.
I really like that bit
at the end where they finally rock up to Cybertron, and there's this moment of silence, and then Hot Rod's like. Cup. Doesn't this remind you of anything? Never seen anything like this before. I was like, yeah, fair enough. It's a good setup. It's such
all
a good
right.
movie! The writing's so witty.
But I don't even- must be unlocked. Here's how to use an ability you don't even have.
Let's test it out.
Nope. Woo!
Well, yeah, you gotta have a shotgun.
Oh well. Let's just go back to the shit that works.
Yeah. That's really overpowered on these dudes.
Oh. Ba-dum, ba-dum. Okay, disco ball.
You know, this game would be much improved by. Fucking laser hawk. I gotta thank Josh for that. I think I have, but it's his fault. He fucking posted Skull and Sharks. It's like, chilling to Laserhawk. Sweet. And I'm like, oh, check this out. Holy shit, this is really good. Check out like the whole album on Bandcamp. This is good music. Fucking, get introduced to Callum. And Callum plays it like almost non-stop. Laserhawk's three albums. When we play D&D, that's like the default music to play. There's three albums we generally play during our D&D with Callum's place. Laserhawk, well, actually, I guess that's technically three albums in itself because it's got three, alternate. But usually Skull and Shark and, or Arrival. But so it's Laserhawk, the Conan the Barbarian soundtrack, and the Guardians of the Galaxy soundtrack.
Yeah, that's a pretty great soundtrack.
It's so good. Sure, you can. Alright, fine. Don't fucking combo into it. Like a fucking noob. Fucking scrub.
I just don't care.
I've always wanted to play. I've always liked the idea of having a fighting game, having fighting game mechanics, but not in a fighting game.
Yeah?
In a different kind of game.
Yeah. Like, so, like God Hand.
Yeah. A little bit. Like pretty much most platinum games, it kind of they kind of fuse the two together. Not exactly, but it's probably the closest so far. You know, like, actually, I'm not gonna say that on recording. Fuck it, that's an idea I actually have or something. So fuck it.
This level is really good at simulating a nightclub. Do you know why?
It's awful.
Cause I can barely fucking hear you. Oh fuck this guy.
Oh, shit, I'm not recording.
Technical difficulty. Yeah. So do you want to go back and repeat all that?
Yes, let's do that.
No, let's just cut to this.
It probably wouldn't have me since the game crashed. I'd say.
Yeah, probably.
I would guess.
Yeah.
That's why I knocked it out. Really
let's
weird.
Let's just do a technical difficulties because nothing of importance happened until now.
Well, nothing important happened, but we were talking about Transformers and Stan Bush.
We can always have that conversation again.
And I'm sure we will.
Yeah. Come on, you fuckhead.
Yes, the three key bits of music we played during the indie. It probably came up in your mic a bit anyway. Laserhawk. His three albums, mostly Skull and Sharks and Arrival. Conan the Barbarian soundtrack and the Guardians of the Galaxy soundtrack, which is amazing.
I see how you do this.
I'm kind of tempted to actually start playing it now so we can listen to it while drove this fight. Like Pina Coladas or...
I think I got it. You kind of have to break his guard.
Yeah.
Like that. But then he just breaks yours.
Oh! Clutch!
Oh! Come on! Come on! No!
Gave him too much of a pause.
Whoa!
Watch it!
What? He reflected my thingies back at me.
Who knew?
See, the only good enemies in this are, like, the non-standard ones. Like, I don't know, even in Devil May Cry, like, fetishes, like, they were basically just powered-up marionettes, but they could still fuck you up. Also, no lock-on only serves to make this shit fucking frustrating.
As you've said.
Yep. Okay, I've gotta get better at that. See?
Yeah, nice.
Nice for him.
What do you reckon the odds are he's gonna be just as tough as the final boss? Or tougher.
This is probably gonna be the hardest thing in the whole game.
Yeah, he's got skills.
Oh, okay.
This is awful EDM over some.
Okay, so either have to break his guard or wait for a lapse. And then break. And then he does that. And then he does that.
Yeah.
Nope, I'm not falling for this.
I just realized I should really have the Transformers soundtrack on my phone at all times.
Might be an idea. I have the Kill la Kill soundtrack on my phone.
Gosh.
That's a great soundtrack. I mean, I never lose my way.
So I think we were saying we both really like the same track from that, because I guess, oh, it's the same. I just realized, yeah, it'd be the same dude, wouldn't it? Because he disappears after every fight.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I was like, I really like the June Cat's Transformation music, and you were like, I really like the
Raggio
sound.
Yeah, Blumenkrantz, that song.
And then.
Da, 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 da. Yeah.
Yeah, and I get to the end, I get to episode 5 where Raggio shows up to watch her face, and. And that music plays, I guess. Oh, I guess that's her music.
Yeah.
I guess we were saying the same thing.
Yeah. It's a great track.
Because it's really. It really.
It's so dramatic.
It contrasts Ryuko's, the Senketsu transformation music. Don't lose your way!
Don't lose your way!
And then it's like. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah.
Here comes the fucker. Here comes Darth Vader, you know. Imperial March.
It's just so, like, grandiose.
Yeah.
Like, it works really well.
I was really hoping, spoilers, if you don't want to know the ending, shut up. Stop listening for a second. Don't stop the video, but just skip ahead 30 seconds from, say, now. I was really hoping when they transformed together, they would have, like, a really well organized mashup of the two, instead of just using, Senketsu.
Yeah, I kind of liked the dual transformation thing, sort of side by side.
Oh, I like that. I was just hoping the music would do the same.
I see. But I know Blumenkrantz is constantly used as like the enemy thing.
Yeah.
So it would be a bit disconcerting. The Maddox, yo. Alright, more porcupines. Ghost Rage. Oh, he looks different.
I really
need to
reconsider what music I have on this thing.
Oh my god, camera! Fucking hell!
You can barely see it to begin with. Just move the camera with your right hand. It's not like you're doing anything with it. Right? That's how it works.
Well, okay, this dude's like...
Wow, they are so not hard anymore.
Blood Rage. I guess it's the same, but I have to
not use
the cheap overpowered weapon.
Suck it. Just blast him with a shotgun, I guess.
Fuck.
Nice dodge.
Fuck.
Oh, right in the fucking face. At least it sounds like it's got good weight to it.
Bam.
So much for not a cheap fight.
Okay. And let me guess. Both ones? Oh. Okay.
Hilarious.
Ha.
I have 2 William Shatner albums on this, on my phone. I can't bring myself to delete them because they're so good. The Transformed Man is fucking great. And so was Has-Been.
This is kind of cheap because you just use, like, the one where he throws him at the enemy and just keeps him stun-locked for so long.
See, even he was like, that was fucking ridiculous. That was just boring and stupid and wasting everyone's time.
Oh, it's going to transition to a completely different level for the boss fight.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not like it'd be a Devil May Cry thing to make you lose the boss fight and then have to do the level all over again, eh? Yeah. Alright.
You gave C-Fox this time.
I really like how it's basically saying, you didn't give a shit.
Yeah.
Have an S. Like, I've died a few times and it's still given me a few good ranks.
Yeah, apparently that doesn't actually take it. That's not actually considered all that much.
Really?
It looks... Well, as far as I can tell.
Because, like, Bayonetta...
You want to use fireworks yet?
Nah. No, Bayonetta, if you use an item, it counts as, like, a quarter or half of a death, depending on what the item is. Yeah. And if you die, like, you're not gonna get a good rank.
Yeah.
Like, even if you die once. Which is shit on the PS3 with the horrible frame rates and the quick time events which require precision. Because of the shitty frame rate, it's impossible to be precise. So you kind of got to guess it and pray and cross your fingers at the same time.
So it's, oh my god. They didn't even transition to a slightly changed scene. Yeah.
Then why didn't you just fight him in the first place? Susan. Rather than get him to go through that whole gauntlet. If you wanted to fight him, why didn't you just fight him?
Soften him up.
Yeah.
Because she's a villain, I guess? I don't know. Is the baby- is the demon baby dancing?
It loves the wub. For a
chance to unwind. Oh, no, don't ruin it! I liked her stupid fucking creepy...
Kaneda!
Tetsuo!
Yeah, this is come basically on. Akira.
What? Out of batteries? Stupid piece of junk. Hey, come down here! Fight with your bare hands! Or
look, it's fucking Akira.
Oh
look.
No, it's the baby.
Now there is a face only a mother could love.
No.
That's... No, it was creepier with her there!
Yeah, it was creepier with her there. I guess she's the weak point?
I don't know. I'd say the eye probably
is. No, the eye. This is some House of the Dead shit then.
Okay, look. Her having a disco theme because it's in a nightclub is one thing, but it's a demon baby. We don't need the neon sound wave. Unless it really does love the wub.
Where are you hiding, Lilith?
Inside, didn't you see? Slice, slice, and dodge.
Oh, there's a glowy blue limb at the back.
Oh, okay.
Pull at it.
I did.
Oh, yeah. She's talking to it like it's a dog. And, yeah. There we go.
I just got a drop of it. Drop it like the bass! And then bam. Wow,
this got really... change of mechanic. Oh.
Phase change.
They have to warn you with a cutscene.
It's blue.
Doesn't that mean it's an angel?
I don't know. Maybe. Oh!
I'm pretty sure that means it's an angel, or maybe. It's helping you fight it! Because it's a fucking mediocre easy game. For babies.
There we go.
A baby could beat this fight.
Oh.
Baby fights! They're the best. okay, that was a good burn.
That was actually really fucking bad.
Yeah.
That's like, not even Josh tier. Oh. No, let me get at you. Ew. What? Whoa. I'm getting decent. I wouldn't say good.
That's what you got the D for. You got the D.
Oh god.
What kind of freak show is this?
I don't know, a demon baby that's absorbed its mother. Freak show. Yes. I don't know. I got nothing. I think we just need this to be over.
Alright.
The baby's down and she pops out.
Yep.
Oh, you pull her out?
Yep.
Get out here!
Oh! Just fly kick right in the fucking face.
Fuck yeah. There we go. Punch that bitch. Oh!
Is he gonna change to red now?
cut the umbilical cord.
Alright, Akira. Oh, what? Did the health come back? Oh, it's two health bars.
Yeah.
As in, not two health bars to go through, but one is Lilith and one's a child.
Yeah, so you'll probably end up with, like, five health bars total.
Yeah.
I wonder what Devil Trigger does on a boss fight.
Yeah, I wonder. Let's try. Nothing.
I was expecting more from this boss fight. Instead of being told exactly where to hit, when to hit it. Instead of going, here are the mechanics. Mm. Jesus Christ, the frame rate's fucking up again.
Yeah, I know. I think it's because of the environment and Unreal Engine.
Yeah, basically. I think they're upgrading that. The new ones come out or something.
Yeah.
Because
they just
details.
Put out... Yeah. I've been meaning to get try out the new Unreal.
No one's really been, no one's really dug into it too much. It's a fairly solid engine. It's made enough games.
True. I know, like, I still think 2K4 probably best use of any sort of Unreal Engine. And, like, fucking great game.
2K4.
Alright. Back to the eye.
Yep.
There's clear transitions ready here.
Yeah, they still have to guide you to it. Yeah, I got a friend, he's made his own little game, he's made his own game engines, just little things here and there.
Yeah.
And like, if you were making a game, like, you know, what would you use, blah blah blah, or would you be able to make an engine that does it? He's like, dude, just use Unreal. It's free to use while you're making it, and then if you make any money, they take a cut. Just
do
it, man.
What's this?
Hopefully something interesting.
The red
change? Now it's a red Wait, stop the reactor. Shit, I got three mouths to feed. I thought you had five children.
Kids.
Shit, you got me. I ain't even married. Oh no, it's still a blue arm.
Yeah, it's still blue.
Now it's red.
It's red. Well, what was the point in
it's
that?
It's got shield, I guess, like armor on it. You gotta pull the armor off and then attack. Maybe we can't see it, but maybe it's holding a tiny little shield. That'd be adorable. I am so over this boss fight.
Yeah, this is taking ages.
It's taking ages to literally do the same thing over and over again.
Okay, I've got to pull the arm down. This is really tedious.
Yep.
That's Ninja Theory. Fuck.
No, Kyle, this game's
really
actually
annoying
really good.
To move from.
And the combat's great, and the boss fights are amazing. Boss fights are some of the best parts of the game, didn't you know?
So how great were Metal Gear Rising's boss fights?
Oh god, I don't remember better boss fights, except for maybe some other Metal Gear fights. But even then, that's probably still better than... I think the best boss fight's the end, like, of all time, because goddamn. Now you get to start again.
Oh, do I just... No, start
probably,
from the
probably
start.
Should have bought a golden orb for boss fights.
Yeah, probably.
For the tedious ones. Too late now. You gotta...
Yeah, I suppose. Alright.
You know how I ended up doing the end part in Metal Gear Solid 3?
How?
I set my clock forward 2 weeks.
You fucking cheater.
That is the... best way to do that fight. Might not be the most rewarding, but it's most interesting.
Yeah.
He's old and he'll die after 2 weeks. I just set the clock forward. Or leave the game for 2 weeks. I thought that was amazing, because if you actually got fed up with the game and decided to take a break, or just couldn't beat him in yeah, 2 weeks.
I suppose.
You log in one day, it's like, Snake, he's dead. He died of old age. What? I actually tried it out and stuff, but I was just like, I'm gonna set it for 2 weeks.
It's pretty hard.
That sounds awesome.
It's great.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Gotta pull her out.
During my next playthrough, I'll do it properly. Yeah, fly kick in the face.
And
eat
then
it, bitch.
Smack the shit out of her.
That's misogyny, Kyall. Do you think it's a time limit or a certain amount of damage?
I think it's a certain amount of damage.
I would say so, because a time limit would, like, imply a certain challenge.
Alright.
Yep.
And then I gotta pull it. And then I gotta slice. Maybe I should save Devil Trigger for when Lilith's hanging out.
I was thinking that. But who knows? If it's a certain amount of damage,
yeah,
it would be wasted, but it doesn't really do anything on the boss anyway, so whatever.
Just, I don't know, makes it a bit easier to hit her. She's a bit slippery, you can't just use Rebellion.
You can't lock on?
Ah, yeah.
What if you just shotgun the fuck out of her while she's just standing there?
That might be
don't listen to me. Then again, if it goes by damage, it does not matter.
Yeah.
You
just
can
make those transitions quicker.
Down.
All right. And then that. We know.
He what? Fucking knows. Are you retarded? Her legs are hanging out.
And then
you've
transition.
Seen her go in. You've pulled her out and seen her go back in.
I said, get out here and fight me, monster.
And then bam, bam. Okay, there we go.
Oh, it's time limit then. It's definitely time limit.
Yep. Okay, let's remember where the health bar is, see if it resets. Oh, it's green now. I've skipped that blue phase.
Wub, 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 wub. Hers doesn't, it's
right.
It does. And it's got one more attack now.
Okay. Oh, there's got to be a better way to avoid that. Oh, that's right. I can grappling hook her.
You can grappling hook in midair as well if you want to. There.
Fuck. Yeah. What the
complacent.
Fuck is up?
Just wait until next time you're out, bitch! Watch it. It's just, don't double jump, just single jumps over it.
Okay. Come
on. It's way too easy in this game to double jump.
Stop showing me your butt!
Nice. I pissed it off. Made it squeal like a pig.
These camera angles are just frustrating to deal with. Come on. Come on.
Show yourself, Lilith.
See, that makes
there
sense.
We go. There we go. Here we are. See that? No!
Just wait for it.
No. Let me get back there.
Yeah, yeah,
come
yeah,
on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Alright.
Pull her out, Devil Trigger.
You make me sick.
And trigger warning.
Trigger warning. If they really wanted to be edgy, that's what they would have called it in this.
Yep.
Yeah.
There we are. There we are.
It's over.
Alright.
That's phallic. It's symbolic. She has to suck his sword penis.
Get up. I'm not gonna kill you or Mundus' spawn.
Penis is just such a better word for comedy.
Yeah,
way
I
better.
Suppose.
She's gonna suck his sword cock. She's gonna suck his sword penis.
Alright. So Mundus only cares about the fucking baby.
Well, yeah.
Oh, that's a like selfish demon thingy, blah, 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 blah. Really? Alright.
Thanks for getting
in. Well, check out that video quality, Dante. Invest in a better internet connection. Regarding your trade-off, though, I'd like to suggest a fucking hell.
Yeah.
This is 2015. The life of your child. Dun dun dun.
Why don't we just make more? I assume there's an involved process for demon making.
Maybe it's like Eldar, how it takes like multiple like impregnations over like a certain amount of time.
The fuck?
Yeah. Sorry, there's like fuck all of them. Because it's like, oh, do you want to have a kid? But it's so hard. I have to have so much sex with you. Wow.
That's awful.
What a great game.
You'll be a limbo star. How low can you go?